Hey there, welcome to the Junk Drawer. My name is Enzo. Welcome to your favorite baseball cap, t-shirt wearing doll YouTuber. So today we are getting a little vintage and looking at some small dolls. So back in the 70s and 80s, I feel like there was like a trend of these like small fashion dolls. I don't know when it started. There isn't a ton of information on these like 4-inch fashion dolls. I'm sure if I took some more time and researched even more, I would maybe find stuff, but there isn't a ton of information. The most information I got was from the one line we're gonna talk about. But before, so I have three dolls to talk about. Two are actually open, one is not open, so I'm very excited about that, so we'll open that. But before we get into it, I want to kind of talk about some of the other lines, because there were a bunch of knockoff lines. Again, I don't know who originated this, but there were a bunch of clone dolls for this form factor with the 4-inch dolls. So I thought it'd be fun to kind of take a look at some of these. And this is by no means an exhaustive list. There are, I'm sure there are more dolls, doll lines out there that I missed. So if you know of any that are not mentioned in this video, please comment below, because I love finding out new doll lines and like lost vintage lines. A lot of the lines that I'll be talking about are kind of, I'm assuming they're like budget lines. I don't know how many of the big toy manufacturers of the day were putting these out, but I feel like a lot of them were not from the big guys. So anyway, let's take a look at some fun 4-inch doll lines. So the first doll line is Simplicity Fashion Designer Dolls. I'm assuming this is one of the like knockoff kind of budget lines. You can just tell by the doll in the package that, you know, it looks budget. You know, you can tell, you can look at something and be like, oh, there isn't a ton of detail. It looks a little off, a little disheveled. And yeah, so I'm assuming this is a knockoff. I don't know. I don't know if Simplicity is the brand or the doll line. It's kind of hard to see what it says in the lower left corner, but yeah. It also comes with two extra fashions, so that's always nice. The next doll line is actually a doll line that I feel like is, or was really popular. This is a doll line, Dazzle, that I see a lot when I search for 4-inch fashion dolls. I feel like they were pretty popular, and I've definitely mentioned these in my live stream before. So yeah, they just look really fun. I love the packaging for these Dazzle dolls. I love the illustration on the right, and then the doll on the left, the colors, the fonts, everything about the packaging is amazing. So I love, and I don't know why I didn't pick up a Dazzle doll. I think maybe that might be my next 4-inch purchase, is a Dazzle doll. So the next doll line, I believe, is from Italy. I think this is Italian, so this is an overseas doll line called the Cover Girl. And I don't know if I can tell who the manufacturer is, but again, I love this vintage packaging. The illustrations will always get me. I always have a soft spot for illustrations, especially vintage ones. I just think it's so cool and so interesting, and it definitely like grabs your attention. The next line we have is Glitter Girls. So this is great. Dresser, poser, styler hair. Again, great illustration. The doll looks cute. It looks like you get a ring too. So I love when they include little extras. And this is from Vogue Dolls. I don't know if that was a brand or a doll line or a toy manufacturer. I feel like I've heard of Vogue Dolls before. So yeah, great packaging. And then we have Pocket Pretty Eva. And this is just a cute, it's a super cute packaging. I've definitely seen like the cutout top before, like that style of packaging on other doll lines. So this must have been pretty popular. I'm gonna assume this is from the 70s. I love that it's a jean. It's supposed to mimic like a jean pocket, maybe like the backside. So the doll is like in the pocket. It would have been cool if they were able to make it so the actual doll was in the pocket, but they just have like a, it looks like a photograph inside of an illustration. So still cool though. The next line is Adorables. So this looks like it was put up by Sears, which is very interesting. International fashion doll. And I feel like this may have also been on the budget side. I don't know. It looks a little budget. I'm not sure though, but yeah, Sears threw their hat in the ring as well. And the last one we have is from Nasta? Rasta? I don't know what it says up there. So it's just called Fashion Gal. And I'm gonna go out on a limb that this is another budget doll. Looks like it was $2. So yeah. Also the fashion is very simple. But yeah. Okay, so now that we've taken a look at some other doll lines, let's actually look at the ones that I actually have. So the first one I wanna show you is probably, I'm gonna assume this was the first one. This is from Kenner. So this is Glamour Gals. And Kenner, if you don't know, Kenner put out G.I. Joes. So the whole thing was they wanted to come out with fashion dolls that were in that G.I. Joe scale. So that's kind of where this originated, this idea. And I don't know that these lasted very long. I know I said 70s and 80s, but I feel like the height did not last very long of these types of dolls, which is a shame because they are super cute. And I feel like now we're seeing a resurgence of like tiny fashion dolls, like with like Mattel doing the mini Barbie Land dolls, and just like dolls in general. I feel like they've been getting smaller. There are plenty of doll lines out there that are on the smaller scale that are not the traditional 1/6 scale, 12 inches. So this is Jenna. She is a Glamour Gal. I picked her up at an antique store. And I think she was pretty reasonably priced, and I was just really excited to see one of these in person because I had talked about them, and then I finally saw one and I was like, I need to get it. So Glamour Girls collection, her legs bend, she can turn at the waist, has combable hair, collect all 15 dolls. So if you can see, so I'm not going to take this one out just because I kind of want to keep it in the package. There is one we are going to take a look at because it's kind of open anyway, so that's why. But I kind of want to keep this in the package because I feel like the package is like part of the appeal of this, and I think it's really cute. So I'm going to try to show you the doll through the bubble here. She comes with a stand, which is amazing. There's a little hole, like a peg hole on her one foot there. You can, I don't know if you can see, but so she kind of plugs, I'm sure she just plugs in there. And then she comes with a little comb here. But the biggest thing that you might notice is that her arms are super dark. So they are obviously discolored from just from time. This came out in 1981, so it's a long time. So yeah, the plastic discolored. I'm assuming it has to do something with the makeup of the plastic from her arms. So this tells me that the plastic in her arms is different from the plastic from her body. So that's always interesting when they do that. I love her dress. Her dress is very of the time. It's very look. It looks like it's very like flowy, and it's like a pleated fabric. She's just got this little flower on her waist, and she's got a cute face. And I feel like the back of this package is kind of like the best part because you can see the other dolls. There's a lot of them. And it's interesting that there are no single male dolls that they sold, but If you see in this set here, there is a boy doll, a male doll, but it looks like it just comes with a set. So that's interesting. But yeah, there are also little play sets and all that. And then you could mail this in for a free doll. So that's cute. Also, one of my favorite things about this particular photo is in tiny wording up here, it says, pose shown may require support by hand. So they don't want to give the illusion that you can pose your dolls like that, which is like, okay. It's like, how did you pose them without hands? So I don't know if it's like, you know, Photoshop, or what. This is 1981. I don't think Photoshop was around back then. I should know this as a graphic designer, and I am blanking on when Photoshop came out. Was it 81? Was it around? I know it was like 80s, but I don't think it was that long ago. Wow, I'm a bad graphic designer, huh? Anyway, yeah, I just thought that was funny that they would say that. So the other doll that I have that's open is this 18 Friends. So this is a different brand. And I kind of love this packaging more. And if this doll was not already, the blister is already open. So that's why we're gonna open him. But if it was not open and sealed, I would definitely keep this intact. But I love this illustration, and just like it's so of the time, and I love it so much. And handsome 4-inch collectible doll with posable arms and legs and doll stand, so very similar to Glamour Gals, and with the illustration and then the blister on the side there. But he also has some discoloration, but we'll get into that in a second. My favorite, I also love the backs because it also shows the other dolls in the collection. My favorites though are the boy dolls on the bottom there. Like, these outfits are insane. Like, come on. Like, I would love to own these two to complete this collection. They're so good. They're so good. Gabe in Rough Rider. This is Todd in Skydiver, and then Barry in Surf and Sand. Like, come on. The girls are cute too. I think my favorite girl is this Trisha in designer jeans. I love the outfit and the colors and all that. So super cute. So this is the doll stand that comes with this doll. And I'm assuming it's the same type for the Glamour Gals one, but it's literally just got two little pegs on it. And then on the bottom of his shoes, there are two little holes, and I'm assuming it should plug in. There he is. And on his little stand, he's a little wobbly, but it technically works. All right, so let's take a look at Todd. So that's his front and his back. He is super, super cute. His outfit is kind of funny because he's a skydiver. I'm assuming this is meant to be like a skydiver outfit, but yeah, it's so weird. I don't think I have any dolls at this scale. So I never collected G.I. Joes or anything like that. So having a doll in this scale is like new to me. So I'm kind of fascinated. So yeah, obviously his head is discolored, just like Jenna's arms. And I'm assuming if I did the same trick I did for the Candy doll, if you haven't watched that, I restored a Candy doll's head who had a very similar situation where the head just went white. And I just used Plastidip to add the color back in. So if I really wanted to, I could do that, but I don't know, we'll see. And then he's wearing this skydiver outfit. It's the material's like, it's like whatever, it's not, you know, it's almost like see-through. I can almost see through to his body. And then it's all one piece. I'm not sure what this is supposed to be. I'm assuming it's part of the jumpsuit, maybe. I don't know. But then he also does have little shoes. These are just painted on. There's nothing, like, they're not removable or anything. It's literally just part of, I think it's painted on. Yeah, it's totally painted on. Those would be the tiniest shoes. But yeah, there's not a lot to him. I do want to take his clothes off just because I'm very curious to what the body type looks like. So give me a second. Let me get his outfit off and I'll be right back. Okay, on second thought, maybe I won't take it off. I'm just really concerned about getting this back on, his outfit, because the openings are like super, super small, and I really don't want to not be able to get the outfit back on. But I mean, I can show you his top part, kind of. There's not a lot going on there. I mean, you can kind of see it. His legs are like bendy, so it feels like a soft rubber. I don't think there are any joints or anything, so it's all one piece. But his waist does move, so there is that. His head moves, and I think that's it. Like, his arms move up and down, and he can move his legs, but that's about it. I mean, that's kind of what else would you expect from a doll like this. But I'm also not sure if this has been, it was obviously opened, but I'm gonna assume that this is all that was included. So yeah, this is Todd from 18 Friends. And the last thing I wanna take a look at today is this package. So one of the, I'm assuming, clones of these dolls is called Pretty Gals. And this came from all the way from Australia. And yeah, so let's go ahead and open her up. So this was packaged in newspaper, and this is from Australia. So this is kind of awesome to see like what Australian newspapers look like. It's either a newspaper or like a rag. Yeah, I think I'm gonna spend some time later and check out the Australian literature. So here is the doll. I am very excited about this one because I was really drawn to the packaging and the price. This was actually pretty cheap for coming from Australia. I was like, wow, why is this so cheap? But I was just like, this doll is like pretty cool. Oh, wow. Okay, so Pretty Gals. Here she is. This is another one I'm probably not gonna open, just because the packaging is like, it's so good. It is so good. So this is from, there's no date on it, unfortunately, but I'm gonna assume this is 80s, maybe early 90s, but definitely from the 20th century. I love this packaging. It's so random, like between the colors and the font and like the grid background, and the fact that the doll is up against this like shiny, shimmery background. I also love her color scheme and the all gold. And I'm assuming these are all the different outfits you could purchase, because this is her right here. And I don't know if it's the same. It looks like it's the same character. So yeah, it looks like you could get different outfits, fully posable. So it looks like Blue Box is the company that made these. I'm not sure if this is a worldwide production or Australia specific. I have no idea. But and it shows the different accessories and play sets that you can get, which was very common for these dolls. Kind of these like miniature play sets. I love these. If I had space, I would definitely get more of these like smaller play sets, but I don't, unfortunately. I do love the light up dream house. So it looks like there are lights in this actual house, which is amazing. So, and there's no, I don't know if like this was it. It's kind of hard to tell. I really do wish there was more information on these types of dolls. And again, maybe I'm just like not looking in the right spots for that information. But if you know anything about any of these dolls, please let me know in the comments below. It's such an interesting kind of subset of like fashion dolls, like the smaller, they're not tiny, but they're not big. They're kind of like in the middle. So there you have it. That was my look at the 4-inch fashion dolls. Let me know in the comments below how you feel about this scale. If you have any of these vintage dolls, I would love to know which ones you have, what brands you have. So thank you as always for watching. I truly, truly, truly appreciate it. If you haven't already, please remember to subscribe. And I hope you have a lovely whenever you're watching this, and I will catch you next time.